As well as the important organization that make sure that we're able to bring this to bear and then great content for you. While we speak to the key political stakeholders, as your election command center and as media general, of course, with all the subsidiaries, we also implore you as the ordinary members of the Ghanaian public and voter population that we all need to contribute to having a peaceful election. And all of us can do that. Make sure you log on to TV3 Ghana, get the latest update from our pages. And when we do the content, you can always join us. We have cash out. And tomorrow, we're building up to that mega jackpot that will be convened. But today, with *439#, you have to choose option 2. You increase the number of the tickets that you have. And as always, make sure that you do that in multiple times, because when we do the draws at the back end of the dashboard electronically, it enables you to have the best of the odds when it comes to the draws. And so you get money credited into your mobile money account. And that's very important. 16 days to this election, we want to discuss with our regular discussants, our beautiful, intelligent women contributing to great public opinion shaping, policy direction, for our country in the run-up to this election, what we need to do to maintain the peace. Already, we have the Coalition of Domestic Election Observers. As far as I know, since I started journalism, they've been undertaking a lot of robust work in monitoring elections. Kudeo, coming up with the latest report indicating vote buying is a critical feature, again, even intensifying this election. Now, the peace is very important. The IGP has been meeting news editors, heads of various media outlets. And there's even a Lieutenant Colonel, who is Lieutenant Colonel Kujo, heading the jungle warfare of the Ghana Armed Forces in Achiasi, again, telling those macho men that they need to be careful. He will whip them to pulp. And so what do you think we need to do to maintain the peace? So we're here to discuss that. Let me just introduce our guest this morning. I have just in front of me, Na Che Ni Ope. Good morning to you, Na.
Good morning,
great,
Roland.
Great, great.
How are you?
I'm well. I'm well. Nice meeting you once again.
Nice meeting you.
And then also, of course, Madam Rodalyn Ayana is with the Great Alliance. And that is the Movement for Change and the Great Alliance. How do you call your alliance, Madam Rodalyn?
Alliance for Revolutionary Change.
Alliance for Revolutionary Change.
And this change. Revolutionary change.
Revolutionary change. And they've been, you know, yesterday I saw a video of Alan Tramanting, and then as I think somewhere in Ashanti region, as he was passing by, then MPP supporters were clad in there, all reached out to him. It was a very funny video. But TikTok is where I live these days. So, and then also a former general secretary of the CPP, and also has worked variedly in public service. I've known him the better part of my adult life, 24 years and counting. Has served Rawlings, Kufuor, John Mahama, Atta Mills, Akufo-Addo. Of course, it was during Akufo-Addo's time that he got off from public office. And so, Nanaya Achempem Jantwa, the daughter of the great Jantwa. How are you?
I'm fine.
A queen of Ashanti. Nice having you once again. But let's again refresh your mind with the IGP and then also the Lieutenant Colonel of the Achiasi Jungle Warfare of the Ghana Armed Forces.
Also to the people who think that they can probably come out with making statements to intimidate and do all that, I want to tell them that life will become very uncomfortable for them. So they shouldn't even try. Because at the end of the day, when you do anything and de-escalation fails, you do anything and engagement fails, when we come and we'll come with the full force of the law in a manner that dignifies us as a people, please don't complain. And it is here that we want to seek your support as we do that in a way that the people will know that at the end of the day, if the police also get it right, they have people to speak for them. Then the normal issue that when we get it right, it's no news. It's normal. But as soon as we seem to got it wrong, even if the facts are now clear, it's a big news. Let's help ourselves to avoid that. So in summary, in terms of the preparation for the election, this is just the excerpt I want to give you to be comfortable and use it to tell your people who listen to you across the country that Ghana will continue to enjoy the peace that it has been enjoying during this period of the election. And even that peace, because of the way all of us will work together to prosecute this election in a manner that winners will know that they have won. Losers will also know that they have lost and they have lost fairly. And therefore, they have no business trying to incite anybody to do anything that will disturb the peace. Will be clear in their mind, and there will be no motivation for them to do that. And this country will continue to enjoy the peace that we cherish so dearly, for which we have become the envy of the rest of the continent.
I am telling you here that I will only come in this 7th December within the Achimansa enclave. When police tells me that they cannot, and when I come, I will not talk. I will beat you and the hell will leave you. I always want people to try me. So those of us seated here, any of you can try me on that day, or try any of my men on that day. When you go to the polling station, just cast your vote, go home, go and sleep.
Thank you.
When it is 5 p.m., come, they will tell you where to stand. They will count for you. If you win, clap, go home. Then you will not have any problem with me and then my people. We are not going to sit down for just 2 or 3 people to distort the peace that Ghana is enjoying. That is why I don't vote. I don't want to belong to anybody, but I want to beat everybody. We have a duty as religion or religious heads, as security heads, as family heads, as individuals, to protect the good things that we have as a country. And the only good thing we have as a country now is the peace that we are enjoying.
That is Lieutenant Colonel Jacob Kujo, the commanding officer of the Achimansa Jungle Warfare School in the Eastern Region. I'll go beat you off. Anyway, Madam Rodeline Nayana, what do you make of the run-up to this election, the trust for the security apparatus based on our recent history and what needs to be done to make sure that we get everything going to get it right when it comes to security for this election? That sort of apprehension that needs to be taken off.
Right. Well, let me say good morning to our cherished viewers. And good morning to Mr. Alan Tremating. Wish you well. Hope you're doing well also where you are. You know, when it comes to the security of elections, you know, the people who are actually supposed to help are the police, not the military. The military only gets called in when the police are not able to handle a situation. So I am not expecting to see military men hovering around polling stations on election day. I am expecting to see policemen and maybe some other security agencies like the immigration, prisons, and customs, who may be roped in if they don't have enough men to go around. What we would be doing, or we would expect for them to do, is to be as neutral and professional as they can be. That means going there and just watching people do the right thing, not intimidating anyone, not trying to influence anyone, and just observing for us to get the peace that we want. This is a very peaceful country. We've had some situations in the 2020 elections that we do not want repeated.
Mm.
We don't want to see another Ayawaso West Wogon on our hands. So all that we can ask for is that lessons have been learned, and therefore we must go into this election with just one thing in mind, that we're all going to go through with what we need to do, wake up, take your card, go to the center, stay in the queue, vote, go home, or if you want to stay around, but keep away from the pool box. That's all there is to it. I don't think that we need any form of threats from the military. I don't think that what Kujo said is something that we really want to hear. No one is asking anybody to beat anybody. No military person has any right to beat anyone. You understand? So you shouldn't even put it in our heads that you will beat anybody. If someone misbehaves, you will call in the police. And there's also the military police who can take that person up and hand the person over to the Ghana Police Service to do with the person what they wish to do with the person. But we do not want anybody manhandling any Ghanaian during this election. It doesn't matter if you are from the military. It doesn't matter if you are from the police or whatever. No Ghanaian must be manhandled during these elections.
If you take a look at our recent history, I covered the Ayawaso West Wagon debacle that morning. I was then doing some work with Joy. So before I'll go to the corporate over, I pass there to cover the election. And you look at the way those security thugs and subsequently what we found out from that commission hearings, the things they did that morning and up to today, nobody is held responsible for it. I mean, it will play on the mind of the ordinary voter, won't it?
Definitely. It will play on the minds of the ordinary voter. And these are some of the things that governments, incumbents do to drive away voters. Because once you have a situation like what happened at Ayawaso West Wagon, people then get even scared to come out and vote. But you see, Rola, let's not lose sight of the fact that we have a lot of miscreants who are not military men, who have gotten access to the uniform. Because from from the Ayawaso West Wagon, for instance, we came to an understanding that some of the people just said, we don't know them. This is not part of us. So there are people who will be there in probably military uniforms, but they are not soldiers. That is the one big problem that we may be facing. You know, those people who are going to come in there, though they are not, because listen, if you listen to the press conference of the NDC, for instance, you know, talking about people being trained at Asatuari and all those things to be put in uniform, you understand, on election day to come and probably intimidate people, then we have something coming. We need to be very careful about such situations. We do not want another Ayawaso. And you see, it's for instance, let's put another look at another angle. At the moment, we have a lot of police and military and whatever all around. It serves as a deterrent. You understand? But when you are using the military to intimidate people for them not to be able to come and vote, I'll give you one example. In the Kusak area, for instance, we are seeing a lot of military people along the road.
When you say Kusa, you mean the Boku enclave, Zabila, Posega, Garu, those areas.
Pane area. We are seeing a lot of military people around, you understand? Under the guise, maybe it's true, of trying to keep away infiltrators from Burkina Faso. But then if you think of the fact that military men went into Garu and beat people up, you have practically made the people afraid to come out and vote, even at the sight of a military man. So we will plead that keep them away from the polling stations. Keep the military completely away. If they have to be by the border, let them stay by the border points and stop anybody from coming in. But for goodness sake, we wouldn't want to see any military person in front of any polling station. Because it's intimidating and it doesn't give the people enough courage to come out and come and cast their votes. It's happening in other places. All we are saying is the military should stay out of the politics until it is absolutely necessary
for them to come in. And if you listen to Kenneth Festus Abuaye, he'll tell you the modus operandi and the way the military are trained, their deployment domestically creates problems, especially in times of elections. Particularly when you know that 8 people died in the last election. Before then, there was, of course, Ayawaso West Wagon, and still no perpetrators are brought to book. Nache, should we be worried or should we not? Your party even held a press conference today for making all those accusations.
Good morning to Roland once again, and good morning to our viewers. Roland, before I come to the security matters, for the past few nights, I mean, it's been sleepless for me.
You've not been sleeping.
Thinking about the cruelty of the NPP.
What have they done to you?
Wanting to feed or having fed school children and wholesome rice. And then when you watch the videos, I ask myself, would I feed these to the dogs in my home? Or would I even feed this to my worst enemy? Roland, you see, so when I make this point and you squint in disagreement, I don't get you. But that is the reality on the ground. That why would the NPP and Danana Adodan Kweku Fuadu and Dr. Baumia...
You're talking about the Mushosho rice rebagging debacle.
...be so cruel to the extent that they would wish sickness and death on young people. Roland, I'm asking you, would you give the visuals we saw of the rice, would you give it to the dogs in your home? Would you?
The ministry said they are investigating.
So that you actually proceed to incur veterinary services. I'm not sure that you would do that. But in the wisdom of the NPP, that's why I keep saying that when wisdom calls, the NPP must listen. And then the NPP must be human enough to admit that they are no more, they are not more human than any Ghanaian. And so what the NPP should be doing is to be rendering an unqualified apology to parents and to students for having put their lives on the line once again. Galamsey put the lives of Ghanaians on the line. Rotting rice put the lives of students on the line. Anytime the NPP attempt to say that they have outperformed the NDC, it is because they have done worse. We need an apology. The investigation must be fast-tracked. And everyone who is found culpable must be brought to book. And I'm wondering why parents are not angry and on the streets. If I had a child in the free SHS and government feeds my ward this food, I'm not sure that I'll take it lightly with government. And I'm also wondering the silence of the Ghana Medical Association that you watch on for government to feed school children with unwholesome rice and then we keep quiet. Where is organized labor? We can't even find them.
No, Chair, the ministry said they are investigating.
Roland, the NPP will continually do what is bad. The NPP is an example of everything bad. Then they will come back and say we are apologizing. It shouldn't be the case. And that is why this morning, I'm happy, though I've been sleepless, that it is just some 16 days to end the rot. It is just some 16 days to apply the brakes on the cruelty, on the incompetence, on the mismanagement of the economy by the NPP. Nothing useful to add there. Now let's come to the security matters. And to let you know that, and so as ordinary Ghanaians, we actually appreciate the role of the security services, be it the police, the military, in wanting to protect the peace that we have. And did you hear the military man who spoke? He says that the only good thing we are enjoying now is the peace. It means that it is an admission that even to the military, the economy is in tatters. It is an admission.
That's not what he said, though. He didn't say the economy. He said we're maintaining the peace.
The only thing that Ghana is enjoying now, the only good thing we are enjoying now is the peace. We are not enjoying any better economic conditions.
He didn't say that, actually.
Roland, he said the only good thing. When we say one, the only means one. It shouldn't be a lecture. The only means one. It means there is none other. And so all other indicators of the economy, whether it's cost of living, whether it's education, what have you, they are all in the gutters. They are all in tatters. What we are saying is that the ordinary Ghanaian would not also, in appreciating the role of the military, actually cower into a certain submission to be intimidated by the military. The economic mismanagement, the high cost of living and the low standard of living has been intimidating and has weakened us enough. And so on 7th December, the assurance we also have for the military is that we would comply. We would go to the polling station. We would vote. And we would be vigilant because, you see, as a political party, as the NDC, and as a Ghanaian, as NACHE, I would not only leave the vigilance to the military, I would not leave the free and fair and transparency of an election to the EC. No. Every well-meaning Ghanaian that wants to see an end to the incompetence we are seeing must be up, right, with anger and in hunger to vote against the NPP.
No. What the man said was that if you vote, leave the place.
You see, I haven't said what the man said is wrong. What I'm saying is that Ghanaians would comply with the directions given by the military. But that doesn't mean that we will forfeit our vigilance. That doesn't mean that we will forfeit our wanting to partake in an electoral process and make it free and fair. That doesn't mean that the presence of police, military, will cower anybody into a certain submission, into a certain fright, so that when we see something, we won't say something. We are active partakers in this election, and no military intimidation, no abuse of incumbency would actually cower anybody into fright. Now, I'll continue with Kodeo's assessment
and concerns they've raised.
There is actually an abuse of incumbency. And that is why I say that the NPP is the example of everything bad in this country. And don't be surprised to hear the NPP come to say that this Kodeo report was instigated by the NDC. Anytime the NPP is caught pants down, they blame it on any other thing but themselves. But Roland, you see, at the core of what Kodeo is saying is that there is a certain wanton dissipation of public funds. It means that the viewer who is watching this morning, his taxes, her taxes are being mismanaged and skewed towards one particular party, and that is the incumbent NPP. Now, to also say that, don't worry, I'll wrap up shortly, to also say that it tells you that the NPP and Nadranko Akufo-Addo and Dr. Bawumia have a sense of entitlement that is repugnant and nauseating to see the
repugnant, to say the least.
Now, the report and the assessment of Kodeo says that NPP parliamentary candidates have actually defaced the drip machines that were deployed to the constituencies, and I'm sure you saw that. Abuse of incumbency is also when, under His Excellency Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, 8 lives were lost in the election you covered, Roland. Until today, nobody has been reprimanded. Even the Emil Short Commission's report that says that Brigadier General Michael Opoku should be actually reprimanded for his supervision of the bloodshed on that day. Today, he has actually been promoted. When we say abuse of incumbency, we are talking about Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo and Dr. Bawumia reckless appointment of party faithfuls in the likes of Dr. Bosman and Dr. Apiahene to the Electoral Commission. That is the exemplification of what we say abuse of incumbency. Now, abuse of incumbency is when COVID did you good and you come back to tell us that COVID did you bad. When in reality, the World Bank gave you 600 million. When in reality, you received 1 billion from the rapid credit facility of the IMF. And their own parliamentary candidate for Sagna Rugu tells us, Felicia Tete tells us that they actually used this COVID money to chew kebab, kelewele, and to share, Roland, don't squint your eyes, and to share for party faithfuls. And so the NPP goes beyond these funds they receive from donors and then come and actually levy you and I. Roland, look at me. Levy you and I to pay COVID levy. That is abuse, right, of incumbency. It is countless. In wrapping up, another abuse of incumbency that should anger all of us, the ordinary Ghanaian, is the fraudulent sole source contracts that Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo has given to his daughters and Dr. Bawumia has given to his brother, who runs the company called Resources Access Limited. If this is not the wanton dissipation of public funds, if this is not abuse of incumbency, I don't know what that is. Finally, Roland,
no.
The good people of Ghana must end the rot. They must end the reckless expenditure. They must end the incompetence. they must end. No words to actually describe Dr. Baumia, but to say that he's an economic mismanager and an oppressor.
At the end of the day, we've come to the point where the security will have to be maintained. But in the run up to that is to making sure that we gain the trust of the institutions that are going to police this election, i.e. the main organizers, the Electoral Commission, for which the Afrobarometer is already indicating trust is already low, even for security agencies, particularly the police. And now we have the military and their role from the last election. How do we make sure that that trust is maintained and get everybody to work towards this?
Roland, good morning. Good morning to your viewers. Good morning to my auntie and my sister here. Good morning to Ghana. Roland, you see, in 2024, 7 December, nobody is going to impose on us a leader that we do not want. Nobody is going to use machinations and tricks to impose on us a leader that we do not want. No intimidation whatsoever. We change the trajectory of history. We change the trajectory of our freedom. We are going to vote in a manner, and we are going to protect the ballot to ensure that whoever we want to lead us will be the person. There's no way we are going to let anybody machinate the poll. It will not happen. It will not stand. There is no way we are going to allow it. No matter what they do, it will not happen. You see, Colonel Kujo, maybe I'll forgive him because he's always been in the jungle. Yes.
He's only managing the jungle warfare school.
But he's in the jungle because if he wasn't in the jungle, he wouldn't speak to human beings like this.
Are you saying he doesn't know what's happening?
He's not used to human beings. That's why he's saying he will beat you. He's not used to being with human beings. So he should start learning. Maybe we should bring him back into the fold of the humans. Because as a measure of sanity, you cannot just get up and say, even your child, you can't just get up and say you want to beat your child. Just for the sake of it. And he was, you see, sometimes we need somebody, I don't want to use the word vulnerable, but we need to be strong. This is a human rights issue. We haven't even started the process. And you are threatening that you beat people. And that even when there is a war or there is some kind of chaos, you will not go hungry because you pick your gun and kill somebody and take their food. Is it right for you to say that? You see, when people are in the jungle and they have not been relieved of the things in the jungle, we shouldn't bring them into humanity. We should let them be relieved of jungle issues before they come. Because seriously, he was talking to civilians.
Certainly.
And he wasn't talking to a command. He was talking to civilians and in a church. And how could he talk like that? Did he listen to himself? And why was he there? He was there to talk about a free and fair election. Why should you go telling people that you're going to beat them? Is he our father? You don't need a father to be beating us.
Or somebody says he's only warning.
Warning against what?
Cautioning.
Everybody knows that you need to leave the polling. There's a perimeter that you cannot go if you are not an election observer or you are not an agent. But couldn't he have said it nicely and kindly? That in case you do that, we will take you out quietly and nicely. Besides, he is in the military. The military is not part of the election. It may be when Dampare gets tired or he's overwhelmed. That's when he's going to bring reinforcement. Talking about another military man who was supposed to be reprimanded but has been promoted. Brigadier Opoku. Brigadier Opoku could...
General.
Brigadier. And that is a top position that you do wrong and you are promoted. Nanadu doesn't love Ghanaians.
Oh, how can you make those?
Of course, because if you love
an experienced politician,
you know, I am telling, if you love somebody, you love a group of people, you would not bring somebody who inflicted pain and promote the person. Nana, the only thing he wanted to do was to be president and have his name in the books of history that he was once a president and his father was also a president. Yes, it's fine, it's a good ambition, but you have to do good by us. How can you? I never knew that this man had been promoted to the high rank of a brigadier general. The man could not look after troops. He could not contain 30,000 people at Ayawa Soweswogo. How can he contain 5 million voters in Ashanti region? How is he going to do that? That's if training. Not chaos. But what training? He said he was responsible for the chaos at Ayawa Soweswogo. He said, you hold me responsible. And the committee said, if we hold you responsible, then we are going to reprimand you. Tell the president, you see, sometimes Nanado, he formed some of these committees just for joke. Just to, of
you
course.
Can't say
that. But why
president with all his experience,
why didn't he implement?
Having become president, is the commander-in-chief of the Ghanaian forces.
Why didn't he, yes, why didn't he implement the recommendations of the Emil Short Commission? Because he is making even a joke of the people. Laughing at them, just a fast. You said that you form a committee to investigate. You see, Nanado should know that he's ruling human beings, not people in the jungle. He's ruling human beings who are alive, who needs empathy, who needs love, who needs care. As a father of the nation, he should think about us. He should not always aggrandize himself as somebody who is like some pharaoh that we should all worship, Ramesses the Second. No, his father was Ramesses the First. He is Ramesses the Second. So he's a pharaoh sitting there, sitting on a high chair, and we should always worship him. No. He should know that what he's doing, we have employed him. We have employed him as the head of this nation. We have given our resources to him to look after. He has dissipated our resources. We don't know what he has used it for. Galam say today oil, we don't, there is no accountability, and now they want to also kill us using this election. We will not die. We will live to declare that Ghana is free on 27 December 2024, and I am very serious about it, you see. But I am very happy, he's a very honest man,
the military man,
yes,
Kujo.
Yes, he said that the only good thing we have in our country now is peace. So he has acknowledged that even free SHS is not working. Ah, is that the only good thing?
Are you behaving like Natre?
What's how is Natre coming?
That's
come
how I understood it.
Yes.
But Roland.
He's just he's saying that free SHS, that the government is always saying we've done free SHS, we've done this. He has told us.
Yeah, but the man only said that the good thing we have is peace.
He said
that with your deductive reasoning, you are saying that.
He said the only good thing, we have different sectors of this our life, different areas. He said the only good thing.
Oh, these women.
The only good thing that we have in this country is peace. So it means that the free SHS is possible.
Did they over me already?
It's possible. He's telling us that the free SHS is not good. He's telling us that the NHIA is not good. He's telling us that the economy is horrible. Because he said the only good thing we have in this country is our peace. And I love him for that. He's been truthful. If only Dr. Bawumia could be truthful like this, we would not have a problem. If only Nanado could be truthful like this, that every day, everything free SHS. You see, Roland, if you have an exam and it is over 10, and the only one you get correct is one, question number one, free SHS. And you have failed all of them. It means you got 1/10. 1/10 is equals to failure. Do you get me? So the man has done well by telling us the truth. Do you understand? All these machinations that are coming up. And sometimes I wonder what is wrong with the MPP. A group of people who are in opposition have come out to say that we have discovered this. That there's going to be some manipulation in Ashanti region. There's going to be chaos. Then you also reply by a press conference saying that the group of people have vigilantes in Ashanti region. If they have vigilantes in Ashanti region going to cause here, you are in charge of the nation. Why should you come and tell us? You should deal with them.
But don't they have a right to complain? They are just a political party.
Your party is in government and you are complaining. Then we are in trouble. That is why we are here, because you can't act. Your party cannot do anything. They cannot act. There is no action. Because if another political party who is in opposition has some vigilantes going to work for them on the 7th of December to create mayhem in Ashanti region, and you are complaining through a press conference, this equalization must stop. Now going to Kodeyo. I've read the Kodeyo, this thing, and me, I have a different view. For instance, they should come back a little bit. They said that incumbency advantage, on the part of whom? We have PCs.
Incumbency advantage.
Yes.
Incumbency means those in office.
No, please. We have PCs, parliamentarians, who are ministers, who are this thing, campaigning. We have Dr. Baumia, who is a flag bearer, and his team. So between the two, which of them is abusing incumbency? Because if Dr. Baumia is abusing incumbency, then he's a Houdini, he's a confident trickster. The point is that, you remember Houdini? He was a magician, and he would trick you. Because Dr. Baumia is always in a bus with his people, branded MPP. I've never seen Dr. Baumia in a V8 on TV. Then maybe what they are showing us is different from what is happening on the ground. That they show us the bus, and when the TV is off, they go back to the V8. Because they are telling us that there are V8s which has stickers of MPP. Do you understand? So they should tell us categorically. Well, what we see with our eyes on TV is like just Baumia says his promises. But
Kodeyo has deployed people around.
I am saying so they should tell us. Because you see, the pieces too are campaigning. So the ministers and the flag bearer, where is the incumbency advantage? Because we need to know. We need to also understand that some of the PCs who are also ministers have V8s which are given to them from parliament. So they need to come and break down to let us know what they found out. So that we know whether Baumia is telling us, His Excellency Baumia is telling us the truth or not. Because we always see him in a big bus. I even saw him yesterday on your sister's station in a bus. His people coming out branded MPP. And people are saying, though, he's using a bus. So
you're advocating for Kodeyo to be more specific?
Yeah, they should be more specific so that we know that Baumia is not, His Excellency Baumia is not lying to us. Because the optics are different from what you are seeing. They also said something like, they didn't see the presence of the other parties, the independents. But they're able to tell us that when it comes to feeding, one to two percent of the feeding of the people who come around
is the political party activity. The
political party is accounted for by the independents and the other party. But they don't mention, they said there's no political activity by the other parties and the independent in their report. So it is more on the NDC and MPP. So how come they're able to tell us that the independents and the other parties also give food, putting a percentage to it? I also want to say that when it comes to politics, sometimes food is not bribe. People come long distances and sometimes you feed them, not to influence them. And they said vote by. I don't understand what they mean by vote by. Maybe influence peddling. But vote buying on that day, because if you...
On TikTok, there are videos of sharing of bags of money, physical money, food on table.
I'll forget. If you give me money today and I finish chopping it, I'll forget. Normally, vote buying is done on the day of the election. When people are going to vote, then you have people mailing around, finding ways to influence them. Do you understand? So there should be some... There are some questions in there and we need some clarity. But on the whole, Afro MPP, they are finished. You see?
The voters will determine that.
But why not? Because you see, when they are hot, they go and call His Excellency Kofor to come and speak for them. When they are in trouble, and you see every time they are in trouble, they go and call His Excellency Kofor to come and speak for them. Me, I've told you this election, you should look at three people. And that is what we are looking at to vote. Any one of them will be
before voted. President Kufuor's message was just to endorse Baumia to say that he's the ultimate. And that he believes that
But why should he come and tell us that?
Why not? He's a former president.
No, but you're a former... I like that. I thought you said that he's a member of the MPP.
No, he's a statesman.
So a statesman does not endorse one person. We have three... typically, we have... For me, we have three people in this race. Alan, His Excellency John Dramani Mahama, then my own flag bearer, I can't take her out. So then you are telling me that All these three people, none can be good. They have a track record. And as a statesman, what you do is that you advise that Ghanaians should vote for the right. Immediately you mention a name, you cease to be a statesman. You have put yourself in the color of a politician.
You think that's why Alan replied him like that? Because the way Alan replied him, someone will say it was not fair.
Alan has even kept too long. He should talk more. Alan didn't reply him. He set the record straight. He said 70% of the policies that made your government successful was from me. And now you are telling me that I cannot be a president. He was just talking about what is in him. Alan shouldn't defend himself. Alan has been quiet all these years. That is where he is today. Maybe he could have been president long ago. I am telling you. So if Alan spoke, there's nothing wrong. Nobody should say that Alan, what he did was wrong. Who is saying that? Alan hasn't done it. He should defend himself.
Even in Ashanti culture, you don't speak to your uncle like that.
He didn't insult his uncle. Me, I also spoke. He's our uncle. Me is my uncle. He didn't say there are words that are insult. He didn't insult. He said, uncle, so you are saying that I'm worth nothing. That is what it means. Do you get me? So if he's a statesman, then he should remain a statesman for all of us. Uncle, I beg you. And I'm reiterating it. I'm very, very worried about this. That you see, as long as there is Alan in the race, we beg him. If he doesn't like John, that is not his party. But we beg him. He should let it be. He should stay. He came back again with another video. Chief is in the race. So we beg him that he should let it be. He should let Chief be and let Chief do whatever he wants. If he thinks that, how can he think that Bawumia is good for us when we are like this? People have died, GDP, an economist who has not been able to turn this country around. A theoretical economist who can write books but cannot apply the theory. Is that what we need? I'm saying that what we need. All of them, this excellency John Dramani Mahama has a track record. Alan Chiamatin has a track record. Do you get me? My flag bearer has a track record through what Kwame Nkrumah did and what the CPP has done for this nation. So I am saying that. Are you saying that Alan is worth nothing? His Excellency John Mahama is worth nothing, and you are a statesman. You see, if the MPP think they are winning this election, why is this happening on free SHS? Vote for free SHS.
Why not? Because it's a good policy.
Because you see, if your soup is nice,
giving access to everybody.
Your soup is nice, you don't ask your husband every day, "Do you like the pepper? Do you
like?"
Yes, your soup, if it is nice, it speaks for you. It speaks for you. You don't ask your husband when your husband's friends are coming. You don't ask him to taste it and see if it's fine. You know that your soup is good. So if MPP, they have worked for us and made sure that this country is in good shape, they don't have to even worry themselves.
Fantastic. We'll be all over the place. It's organized. So I'm really not surprised because... How do you prove to all of us that the second lady was using the military helicopter? Do you have proof? You just don't make that statement. The last time I checked, the second lady was also traveling in a bus, branded bus, Bawumia bus. That's what she used. The last time I checked, the Dr. Bawumia has his bus, which is used for a whole year. I am part of that team, and he's always in the bus when we travel. When he says he's going for his campaigns, he travels in the bus for his campaigns. He hasn't used, the only time you see him using a V8 is areas where definitely the bus cannot go. That one, you see him in a V8. Apart from that, for the past almost one year, 3-4 months, is the bus that he's been using for his campaign. So when you sit here and you attack the second lady without any evidence that she's using the military helicopter, and because she's using the helicopter, a military man had an accident and couldn't be airlifted. I think you should ask her to prove it. Otherwise, she's just tarnishing the image of the second lady. The second lady is working very hard. I want us to go back into history. I come from the Bono region, and the Bono East region.
Bono East.
Bono and Bono East. Let's put them together. You know, they were divided, region, so the Bono half region. And if my memory serves me right, 2016 elections, we had billboards, former President Mahama, in my region, without his vice, the late Mr. Arthur. The billboards had him and his wife, Madam Lordina Mahama. I had been at funerals, one in Soko, one in Tyne, one in Wenchi, where the former First Lady arrived there in a military helicopter. There's nothing wrong with it. If she has to do an official duty, and that is the means to get her there, there's nothing wrong with it. So I would not, until there's proof, and even if the second lady did take the military helicopter, there's nothing wrong with it. That is part of the parcel of their jobs. And I don't think we should set them up for attacks. Mm-hmm. Now about the military man who, is it the Achiasse?
As we were talking, Lieutenant Colonel Kujo, yes. The jungle warfare base in Achiasse.
I did hear him. Mm-hmm. And I honestly do not think that he meant any evil. He was just giving us appropriate warnings. What he said, if I listened to the
audio
or the video, if I saw it, well, he said when you vote on 7 December, go out, go and vote, go to your house. When it's time for the counting and coalition, and he wants,
and you can come back.
You can come back. The police will direct you on where to stand. And when you come, stand there, observe what is going on. If you win, you clap, you go home. If you don't win, you go home, because, I mean, that's an election. And that if you come and you misbehave, and the police call them, then he added the rest to it. And I think it's fair warning.
As a leading politician, would you say that he misspoke or he
didn't? I don't think he misspoke. He's a military man. We have had incidences where people misbehave. The military are called in. They react, and then we end up blaming them. So we should also behave. Every single member of this society should behave. If you decide that you are going to misbehave at the polling station, you want to go and carry ballot boxes, you want to go and disrupt the elections, of course, you will get a reply. The military, the police, everybody is telling you that they will not allow you to misbehave. So why are we up in arms about that? Or we intend to misbehave? If you are like me and you do not intend to misbehave, you really don't care about the warning. So those who are up in arms about this, maybe they have plans to misbehave. That is why they are so
bothered. You're saying those who are raising qualms about this are those who intend to foment trouble?
Maybe. Otherwise, if you don't intend to foment trouble, I don't see why you should be bothered about what a jungle warfare
commander
in Achiasse is saying. I vote in Wenchi in the Bono region. I don't intend to go and misbehave. So what the commander have said in Achiasse, I'll take it in good faith and I move on.
The trust for the institutions of state that need to keep the security, knowing that we've had a recent history, the Ayawaso West war gone, the death in the last election, and making sure that we just are able to trust them to keep that peace for us pre, during, and after the election period.
This is our 8th or 9th election from
1992.
I think this is our 8th or 9th, one of them, elections.
We're going for the 9th one.
The 9th one. Mm. We've had issues before. Every election, we do have issues. Different kinds, different levels of issues. Ghana didn't bend. I do not think that after going through this experience for 9 times, this is the time that we are going to bend. We'll go for these elections. The winner will be declared, and that winner, hopefully, will be Dr. Bawumia. Ghana will move on. So, I mean, this business about not trusting the institutions, these are the institutions we've worked with. And as it is, the modus operandi of the opposition NDC, when it's getting to elections and they know that they are losing or they have lost in advance, then they start attacking everybody, all the institutions of state. That is how they are. We have seen them before. They will not get systems ready to count their vote, no. They will not get things done, no. They would rather go attacking institutions. They started off with attacking EC. all manner of stories. It didn't pan out. Then they jumped on the police. It didn't pan out. Then they jumped on the military. So 2020, if I remember, they are comms, we call it director, their comms officer, national, was there threatening police and military that when they come into power, they will sack them. That is how they are. So for us, I mean, we are not bothered. We have trust in the police to do their work. Governments have changed hands. Nothing happened. Parties were in power, they lost. Nothing happened. In 2008, the MPP lost by a very slim margin. Ghana didn't bend. In 2016, the NDC lost by a wide margin. Ghana didn't bend. In 2024, the MPP will win by a wide margin. Ghana will not bend. That's for this perception of trust and things. 16 days to elections. I think we have gone through this enough. The police will do their job. The EC will do their job. The political parties should also go do their jobs and make sure that we go through this and go through it well. Then before I get it, I find it quite funny that people are up in arms about President Kufuor endorsing Dr. Bawumia. The last time I checked, President Kufuor was one of the founding members of the MPP. President Kufuor hasn't told any of us that he has left the MPP. He is still an MPP member. And I'm sure he's going to be an MPP member for the rest of his life. So if an MPP member, a former president, decides to endorse the candidature of his party member, why are we up in arms about it? Were we expecting President Kufuor to go and endorse John Mahama or Alan Chiramanti or Madame from CPP? I mean,
mention my name.
I know you, your flag bearer. She's a woman. I just don't get her. I've forgotten her name. That's why I said, what's her name? Frimpoma.
Frimpoma.
Madame Frimpoma from CPP or any of the other candidates. That would be totally out of character. And that will not be a statesman-like. We all know who President Kufuor is. We all know where he started from. And we all know that he's a former president and he became president through the MPP. So what is wrong if he endorses Dr. Bawumia? As I said, when you know you are losing an election and you are trying hard to grasp straws, and Tassie has caught you, this is what you do. People should leave President Kufuor alone. He has the right to endorse who he wants. I keep on telling the NDC, if they have treated their former leaders well, I'm not God, but maybe one of them would have been around to also help endorse them. When you call your founder, the whole person who founded your party, you call him a barking dog and that you have caged him. And now the man is gone. And now you have lack of leaders in your party. Then you are jealous of somebody's leader. You are jealous of... I'm not using death to insult anybody. I said, when you people were speaking, I was quiet. I said, if the NDC had treated perhaps their leaders well, and I gave a case, an example, if they had treated former president...
That's right, it's Alan who raised the issue.
It's not Alan. The NDC went at him. They insulted President. Well, you've forgotten that two of their people went bonkers, insulted the old man, insulted him with his disability. So you don't have leaders in your party. Your people are gone. Yes, the MPP too have lost people. But perhaps if you had treated people well, they would have been there to talk for you. Don't be jealous of us. We are proud of former President Kufuor. We are happy he's with the MPP. He's a founding member of the MPP, and we are very happy that he's with us. And we thank him for his endorsement of Dr. Bawumia, because he said it. Dr. Bawumia is great material, and he will do wonders for Ghana. So please, as for Mr. Alan Chiramanti, we are all with you. You decided you don't want us again. You have left. Godspeed, well done. President Kufuor didn't leave with you. President Kufuor did not leave the MPP when you left. So what is his beef?
He says that he's a statesman in the category in which he finds himself.
So?
And that he has a personal affinity not only to him, but also to Dr. Mahmoudou Bawumia. And so in such circumstances...
You do not determine what President Kufuor does. As I said, he's a lifelong MPP member. He's a founding father. When you decided to leave, and you were also a founding father, and you decided you didn't want, I think Mr. Chiramanti is or was the founding father of the MPP.
Not was, is.
Is.
Okay. He's not yet passed.
Well, he is the founding father of the MPP. And you decide along the line that you don't want to go with us again. You don't agree with us. You feel that you've been slighted. All of us have said, okay, bye-bye. What's your problem with the MPP and our members and what our members decide to endorse?
Just 2 minutes for you. Let's try and wrap up. Our time is up. Now, so maintaining the peace, what should be the caution to your members and everybody else? The security apparatus, the electoral commission, making sure on voting day, and then also thereafter. You know, Techiman South happened after the polls, late in the evening. It was even live on TV.
No, so I would only urge all peace-loving Ghanaians to vote peacefully. Against a party that doesn't love peace, and that's the NPP, I'll show you shortly. Because you see, when we sat here and we spoke about the 8 lives that were lost in the 2020 election, until today, not even one life has been accounted for. I'm thinking that the right thing to do is to at best account for the lives, right? Or reach out sympathies to the families who lost their relatives. But at the beginning of this submission, and Naya mentioned something, that the president doesn't care about us.
How?
And so if the president doesn't care about us, we care about ourselves and our peace. You ask me how? I'll render this in Chi and Ga. Omo omwewu, right? Omo omwewu, enfanuhu. Omo omutiase, omo nkwanfanuhu. Omo omwewu, those who are dead are the 8 lives we lost. Omo omutiase are the people of Efutu and the victims of the Akosombo spillage. Who the president says that you deserve your pain, and Adanko Ekufuor-Addo looked in the faces of chiefs in Efutu and victims of a spillage that his administration supervised and told them that you deserve the pain.
The president didn't say that.
What did he say? He says that you deserve this pain. And then it is because I am here as a president, I wouldn't have come. Because you don't even vote for me. It means in the estimation of the president, it is only those who vote for him that deserve something good. Anytime you make an attempt to vote against the president, Adanko Ekufuor-Addo, then you deserve all the hell. So my urge beyond the peace is to the good people of Ghana, that we are some 16 days away from resetting the country. We are some 16 days away from actually saving ourselves from the clutches of the wicked, incompetent, reckless Akufuor-Addo Bawumia administration. Because for 8 years, what have they done? They have actually deteriorated every fiber of the economy. They don't care whether you lose their life in an election. They won't hold anybody or reprimand anybody, even when a commission says so. If any tragedy befalls you, if you are not voting for them, they are not coming to your aid. That is the kind of precedent and vice the people of Ghana voted for in 2016 and 2020. This is an opportunity. 7 December is here again. For us to right the wrongs that we did and vote for His Excellency John Dramani Mahama, who in the face of crisis will not heckle us, who in the face of crisis will not make mockery of our situation. Get your voters' ID card, good people of Ghana, and vote against the elephant. And then to land, it will shock you or interest you to know, even the MPP parliamentary candidates are not in support of their flag bearer. In my own constituency, Lejokuku, the team there is actually campaigning for JM. And similar instances have been reported.
It cannot be.
Are you a politician? I'm a politician. I'm on the ground, and I'm telling you what is on the ground. They've actually left their flag bearer alone. And then they are campaigning for His Excellency John Dramani Mahama. But let me tell the good people of Ghana that we are not going for skirt and blouse. We are voting for the umbrella for presidential and the umbrella for parliamentary. Yes. So that we end the rot and reset the country.
2 minutes.
Mm. You see, how do we get everybody to comport
Know why we are even talking. You know, remember His Excellency Nanado went to Kumasi and said that you can vote for NDC or whoever for all he cares.
But you mean when the host asks him about the concerns that were raised about roads?
Yes, I don't know even why we are doing. He said you can vote for NDC or for any other party for all he cares because your vote is yours. So he's not. So today, if he says in his heart, he doesn't care. Now he's campaigning for Bawumia. But he's the same person. So which one should we believe? He said it on Otek FM in Kumasi. That, I mean, for all he cares, you can vote for it. All person to men this year, family, who may now be a person to men, be a what buy a what back. This is what he said.
Are we not misrepresenting the president?
How?
What, it was a complaint about development.
It does
I think,
not matter.
He said he was going to do it on no, at his face because the conditions have been put in place.
He said something that was in his heart. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. Is it not on record that he said that? It is on record that he said that. Do you get me? So, I mean, and you see, the life of Ghanaians is worth 46,000 Ghana cedis. Because compensation was given to some of the families ahead in Techiman, and they gave one of the families 46,000 Ghana cedis, which is equal to the price of a Pragya. Pragya is 45,500. And the compensation that was given to one of the eight, the families, was what? 46,000 Ghana cedis. Can you imagine? Can you just imagine? This is how worth we are. This is how the MPP sees us. This is how the government of Nanadu Danko Akufo-Addo and His Excellency Baumia, this is how they see us. 46,000 Ghana cedis. That money, I don't think, could have even done the funeral. 46,000 Ghana cedis in this Ghana. Is that fair? Is that right? I am asking you, Roland. Is that fair? You see, there's a video going around. We want peace, and we should have peace. But there's a video going around of somebody saying that the election is the first day of the election. Everybody is voting for number one. I have it here.
What's wrong with that?
Everybody. And that's after the second, third day. We will vote.
Oh, you mean Ohinibao of Is It One to Me? Yeah.
Yes.
That we're going to have two elections. Yeah, but that's not true.
But it's going round. What kind of dishonesty is that? And that will also is a form, a basis for creating chaos. How can you say that when you vote number one, then the rest will be done later? Can you just imagine this? Do we really want peace? And you see, my sister Ellen here, we are not here to speak for MPP. So if whatever it is, we are not... No, seriously. I'm not happy with her statement. That when she was listening, we are all against. We are not here. We have not been employed to sit here. MPP hasn't given us a contract to speak for them. We are here to speak for the nation Ghana. To make sure that Ghana is good. If Atasetase has hit us or not, that is neither here nor there. That is their own business. But we are not sitting here. I didn't leave my house to walk through traffic, to drive through traffic, to come and speak for MPP.
Daniel, I am also talking opposition. About peace.
I am saying,
run up to this election.
So that is the peace I'm talking about. So some of the things that we say will not bring peace. If you say Atasetase Achimia, then do you know what it means in Ashanti? In Chi?
What does it mean?
It means that, like Makov.
Makov, say.
Amaye Basabasa. No, yes, but how can you say that? You cannot say that. That's exactly what you meant. You cannot say that.
She says that's her opinion.
No, I am saying
that.
If you say that your opinion is that we should not come here and talk, but you don't add and insult us. Do you get me? Ellen shouldn't come sitting here insulting us.
We're talking about peace in the run-up.
No, but if this is peace, you should also preach peace. If this is what they are bringing, we also give it to them.
Okay. Ellen, how do we get everybody to this election, knowing that they have a mind that
Roland,
they need also
here,
to trust?
You sitting here as the moderator.
I'm not for questions.
I am saying that we need to make things right because Ellen cannot come here and insult us. And I mean that, and I'm not joking. Don't brush it over. I am serious. She should stop it. She should stop doing that. We tolerate her so many times. She should stop doing that. Ever since she came, nobody has insulted her. Even when she does it, we keep quiet. We treat her as a younger sister.
Peace.
I'm serious.
Peace.
I'll repeat myself.
Peace.
What I said was, when you are losing an election and you are disorganized and you don't know what to do, what you do is that you go on an attacking spree. And that is exactly what they have done. So I repeat it in chief. Atasetase Achriong. And that is why they are doing what we are saying is that in the next 16 days, we are going to vote.
She can't come here to come and speak.
We are voting for Dr. Mahamadou Baumia because he's the
only
He's the only candidate who can move Ghana forward. And as I said, I'll repeat again. When you're losing an election, it's a difficult process. So, I mean, you have to process it. Dr. Baumia is winning hands down. We've gone all over the country. As we speak now, he's doing the final touches in the northern region this morning. Mm. There were some few constituencies he couldn't finish doing his turn. He will do that, and I'm sure he'll be in Accra on Sunday to come and finish the little ones, the 2, 3, 4 constituencies that are also left. So we are mopping up. And we have
So what's happening is a mop-up?
Yes, we are doing the mop-up. Okay. We have run an excellent campaign. And Ghanaians have understood what we are saying. And on the 7th of December, in 16 days' time, Ghanaians are going to vote for Dr. Baumia and continue with all the good works that we have done. And the next 1 hour, the Ministry of Education, too, with the President, I believe the Minister of Education...
Is it today they're launching the 80
We are going
projects.
To launch 80 multiple projects that has been done and by the Ministry of Education. So I think we should all tune in and listen to it. But we are winning this election, and it's obvious.
All right. So thank you, ladies.
I've not had my 2 minutes.
Let me give you 2 minutes. Auntie Rhoda, you and I go way back.
Yeah, I know we go way back. So sometimes you forget.
I apologize.
Yes.
Profusely.
So I just want to tell Ghanaians that we are the crossroads. We've had 32 years of the NDC and the MPP put together, and we are still where we are. We have not improved our lives. And I am asking that this time on December 7th, 2024, you will give your votes to Mr. Alan Tremating, an independent candidate. Let us give these two parties a shock. Let Ghanaians choose Ghana. And that means choosing Mr. Alan Tremating and the butterfly. We are also asking you to know and ask yourself, within yourself, whether your lives have been bettered with these two people in power over the last 32 years. So let us go into the polls thinking first of ourselves and our future and our children's future, and then giving our votes to Mr. Alan Tremating and knowing full well that he is going to be able to create those jobs using the same natural resources that we have. We have so many water bodies, we have the land, we have good sunshine, we have rain, and upon all that, we are still suffering. We have got a solid plan. We are not talking of manifestos. It's not a promise. It is a plan. And that is what we intend to use to change things around for this country. And we expect you at home and wherever you are to give
Auntie
us your
you
mandates.
Look good in the yellows. Beautiful.
Thank you.
Please put the medium shot there and let me see.
Yellow is sunshine, beautiful. It's beautiful and it's
all
bright.
Right.
And that is what
Delhi says, Roland, today, dear, all the ladies are on you. Naraya is even... Anyway, thank you, ladies, for coming. And I hope that the next time traffic becomes bearable. All right. Let me just read this one. It's been a while I've read Zach's, the message you just keep. Roland, it is so funny when I hear people saying ex-president Kufuor is a statesman, so he shouldn't have endorsed Dr. Baumia. The question is, which political party made him a statesman? The late President Rawlings endorsed Professor Mills and Mahama as NDC presidential candidate. So what is wrong then for former President Kufuor to endorse Dr. Mahamudu Baumia? He ends or concludes hypocrisy and dishonesty. Master Planner Junior King Tampo. And then also have this one coming from Prince Ahmed. Says, regarding the MPPC campaigning for John Mahama, it's very true. Even in Asawase, the MPP candidate is begging people to vote for him, and then JM on the other hand. Prince Ahmed, give me evidence. Seth says, if the MPP trusted the police, and for that matter, the security agent, why did they then bring in the mercenaries as being reported from, you're saying, Croatian South Africa? All right. I have this one from Mose Boateng from Inshaiso in Kumas, who says that Dr. Mahamudu Baumia is winning. Come to Ashanti region, and the response is massive. Roland, be there in your studio and be thinking that Accra is Ghana. All right. And so for all those who gave us messages, we're grateful. Also those on stream, we're very grateful as well. Thank you, beautiful, intelligent ladies. I wish you well in the campaign. But look, it's 16 days to the big day, December 7, 2024. We are your election command center. At the end, before we wrap up, we'll bring to you Women's Manifesto. But in the meantime, Merlin Resorts is giving you an escape where love and magic all come alive. So choose from their exclusive Christmas packages for couples. And the common features for these packages include a full board meal plan, breakfast, lunch, dinner, assorted local beverages, and they're also providing great dispensers all at your comfort. The breakfast is accompanied by soothing morning classical songs. So imagine all of us sitting here, even though we're talking, then there's cools, you know. Lunch at their upscale Kente Grill restaurant, romantic bonfire dinners at the gazebo garden, access to swimming pool, state-of-the-art gym all available, as well as in-house games. Now, 10% off is on the spa services, point and kill fish package, and these are the packages. On the first day of the Christmas package, goes for 3,700, and this is ideal for a short getaway. On the second day of the Christmas package, goes for 5,700, where you get one night, get the second night free. Dinner on arrival and breakfast all on the final day. On the third day of Christmas package, goes for 6,900 Ghana cedis, where you stay two nights, you get a third night complimentary. Okay, so make sure that you enjoy this great luxury and relaxation. Treat yourself and your loved ones to an unforgettable experience at Marlin Resort. So just in case you want to book, do quickly. Contact these numbers. 0592026622 or 0592024591. Or you can also give them reservation email. So reservation at marlin-resort.com or check them out, Marlin Resort, on their website. All right. We're taking a break, but we also have to tell you that you can get the latest news updates as you cash out. *439#, always available for you. Cash out, choose option two, win as many times as you can. And I tell you that the election season, 3news.com is available for you. So we go beyond the news and the stories to bring you more. So our special election portal brings you historical results, insights into Ghana's voting patterns, and all the election data that you need, plus live voting updates on election day, pre, during, post. Our interactive maps and detailed analysis will help you stay fully informed. So get all your election information on 3news.com/elections, all right? 3news.com/election is your one-stop election portal. We're taking a break. *439# will be your short code. We'll be right back with you choosing option two, increasing the number of stakes as we come back to look at how well we're doing and do the draws.